And typically, we need to also have a long-term plan. Like I mentioned, it's not just a one-year plan, but it should be at least 4 to 5 years kind of plan one need to make. So what is your vision for 5 years or 6 years is something which we need to start with. And then how do we reach there? So for reaching that, what is the year one plan, year two plan, year three plan? So that's a kind of plan as an organization we need to look into. Typically, there are three stages in formation to growth of any FPO. Initially, it is about incubation and early stage where you identify members, get them, mobilize them, build their capacity, go for registration, provide technical support, and then create professional management systems. So it may take typically 1 to 2 years period for the initial stage. Second stage is about having a growth plan. So having come together, making a plan, establishing systems. Then if you look at growth, how do we grow? From where do we go from here? What are the opportunities available? What kind of market access is required? Do we sell in the local market? Do we collectivize and process and sell? Or do we sell raw material depending on the market needs, local market needs? And then what are the regulatory requirements based on what we want to sell? Say, if you want to sell vegetables, there could be certain kind of legal requirements. If you want to sell grains and process and sell, there could be other set of legal requirements. And if you want to process and sell, there could be different legal requirements. And typically, if you want to export, there would be other set of regular requirements. And depending on your claims, say, for example, if you are claiming as organic, there would be another set of regulatory requirements. So depending on your growth plan, market access, we should look at what are the regulatory requirements an FPO requires. Then what are the business management requirements you have? How much finance you need? What is the kind of infrastructure we need? And what is the way we can mobilize those finances is something which we need to look into. Then comes the stage where the producer organization can get stabilized and they can also develop their own products. So product development becomes critical. If you are into mass production of the same product which everybody else is producing, competing in the market would be very, very difficult. Getting access to better markets would be very difficult. You will end up only as aggregator. So we can certainly do that. That's not a bad choice. But say if you want to sell rice, there will be 100 others who will be selling the same rice. So why should somebody buy from you? If you want to sell dal, there will be 100 others who will be selling dal in the market. So why somebody else should buy from you? Either you should your product should have a specialty, or your product should have it should be cost effective. So either of it is what one need to look into. So that's where product development comes into picture. Then look at business expansion, what kind of partnerships are required, and then we move on. So typically FPO should look at making this as a strategy. And what we also found is we don't make the institutional structure clear. We just think everybody has the same role and then all doing all the activities kind of thing. Technically speaking, every FPO should have a general body which meets once in a year. So all members will be part of the general body. And there needs to be an executive body which can take decisions, but this is an optional one. It is legally not bound, but having an executive body which can take the key decisions would be better, because entire general body meeting so may not happen when is required if you want to take a strategic and critical decision. So having a small executive body always helps. So general body and executive body has a governance role to play. So the governance role is in terms of strategy planning. So where do we go? How do we do? What do we do? What is the plan for this year? And then are we going in the right direction? So advisory role, and then the decision making. So this year, how much business we do? Where do we buy? What do we buy? That kind of decision making is the role of the general body and the executive. Whereas the execution role is the board of directors, CEO and manager, FPOs, and the staff, FPO staff. Their role is about the execution role in terms of planning, implementation, and management of the approved plan. So that's the role of the board of directors and CEOs and managers. Board of directors, since they come from the general body and the executive body, they also can be, they also have a kind of governance role. So in terms of connection between the governance role and execution role, board of directors role becomes very, very critical. So making selection of the board of directors is a very, very critical step, and building their capacities becomes very, very important. Then comes the support role, support in terms of production planning or providing technical support. So who does these kind of support? Do we get support from the line departments, or we built based on the community resource persons, or we have a combination model is something we need to figure out. Similarly, local entrepreneurs. So in terms of input production, say seed production, food processing, or any of these things need not be taken up by the FPO, but FPO can look at who in the village can do some of these activities. If they are smaller, if an individual can do, I think it should be done by the individual. Any activity when we are deciding, if it can be done by an individual, it is better to be done by an individual. Only when it becomes bigger, where an individual cannot handle, an individual or a household cannot handle, then it should become the role of the FPO. Otherwise, if any small activity also, if FPO get into doing it, it becomes extremely difficult, because decision making becomes very, very difficult. So when doing this one, the key challenge is that day one, the members may not have all these kind of skills. Extremely difficult. We can't expect that day one people have all these skills. Well, typically this is what is our expectation. Day one, they may not have the skills. If day one, they don't have the skills, how do we impart those skills? So to impart those three skills, we take support of the support organizations. It could be a local NGO, it could be a resource organization, it could be a state department of departments, so, or individual consultants, anyone. So, but basically we take support. And when we are taking support from a support organization, the very initial stages, it is about mobilization of farmers and then doing the initial registration, those kind of things. Whereas once we start moving up into specialized activities, you need a different kind of capacity building. You need a different kind of forward and backward linkages. So this transition, which are a transformation which happens in an organization, is where actually many of us fail to understand. We expect the same NGO which has run a program on watershed management or we expect them to mobilize farmers, also people also run their business kind of thing. So I think that's, is anyone individual or one individual organization may not have all these skills. So that's where we need to get into kind of partnerships where these kind of support services can be mobilized. If we don't do it, and we, if we expect that farmers themselves will do all this, or one NGO locally available with very meager staff does that, I think is going to be extremely difficult. This is the structure of FPO plays a very, very important role, and we fail to design that one. So design a good structure. And when we are designing the structure based on the local capacities, we need to also design who plays this role, which role is played by whom, and then what kind of support is provided by which organization. So I think that is something which is very, very important. But all these supports are extremely needed to, for an FPO to become economically viable.